No, another AI video? Really?
I know. It is all AI on the clock slot tegenwoordig, as we say here in Belgium. But look, the thing is, the improvements that AI is making when it comes to being more productive and editing video, it's scary. And this new AI plugin, AutoCut for DaVinci Resolve that I've been using, some of its features actually impressed me. So the plugin is called AutoCut, right? And it's a plugin or extension for DaVinci Resolve, and you can use it in both the studio and the free version of DaVinci Resolve, by the way. And that's nice because a lot of the new AI features in DaVinci Resolve 20 are only available in the paid studio version. But then again, if you want to use AutoCut in the free version, you're gonna have to pay for AutoCut. So, you know, there's no way of getting all these new AI features for free. But anyway, AutoCut also offers a lot of features that Resolve 20 doesn't have. And like I said, some of them are really impressive. So maybe the AutoCut features match your workflow better. So if you're just looking for AI features, maybe AutoCut is what you need and not DaVinci Resolve Studio. But totally up to you to decide. I'll show you all the features and the results, and then you decide. And the first one is, yeah, it's already a classic AI feature, right? AutoCaptions, or auto-animated captions. And it's also available in DaVinci Resolve since the version 20 update. So which one is better? Well, this is how it works in AutoCut. Just select the AutoCaptions tool, and right away you can select if you want to use the entire timeline or just a section. Then select the language and open the caption editor. It will start transcribing your video, and boom. This is the captions editor. So you can choose from a selection of presets. There's also community presets. That's pretty cool. But of course, you can also customize your captions, colors, animations, fonts, however you want. Apply and done. And then it adds the captions to your timeline as adjustment clips. And the DaVinci Resolve built-in animated captions, well, it works a bit differently. First, you have to create basic subtitles, and then Resolve will add a subtitle track. And then go to titles here in effects and drop one of the animated title presets on your subtitle track. And then here in the inspector window, you can customize that preset however you want. So which one is better? Well, I feel like they're both great. The main difference in my opinion is that AutoCut has a lot more presets, but the result looks great with both. AutoCut Silences. DaVinci Resolve 20 also has this new feature to remove silences, but the problem is that while it does remove the silences and it does a great job, it only removes them in the audio track. So when you go back to your timeline, you'll see that it didn't cut the video. It just removed the silences from the audio track. But in AutoCut, I mean, the name says it, right? AutoCut Silences, it also cuts the video clip. So if that's what you need, AutoCut does it better. Okay, so this is the only feature that I didn't test because, well, I don't do podcasts, I don't edit podcasts, I also don't do a lot of multicam editing, and, you know, I don't think it would be very useful to test it with a fake 30-second podcast. You know what I mean? Because the whole point of this feature is to make editing an hour-long or 2-hour, 3-hour-long podcast easier and faster. So I've linked some videos specifically on this feature in the description because it's one of the features that AutoCut is famous for. So if podcasts and multicam editing is your thing, go check out those videos. And then we have AutoZoom. And AutoZoom, you use it to add these zooms to your videos. And again, there's a bunch of parameters to adjust, some presets. You want to keep it calm or more energetic. How much do you want to zoom? Zoom speed? Plenty to customize. But it's not very good. Look, the thing is, and this next part is done with AutoZoom. The thing is that when I add zooms manually, I add them intentionally and with a purpose. I add them whenever I make a joke or when I want to emphasize something or when I say something important or, you know, when I make a point. And AutoZoom, I don't know, it seems like it just adds random zooms without taking what's being said and the context into account. You can see it, right? So, you know, I can see the potential, but it needs a lot of improvement. So I had already tried a few of these AutoB-Roll features before AutoCut, but I have to say AutoCut is one of the better ones. And I also know exactly why. It's because AutoCut doesn't want to do everything automatically. It does just enough automatically to save you time, but it also leaves enough for you to do manually so that the result looks good. And that's the magical combination with AI features, in my opinion. So AutoB-Roll simply transcribes your video and then detects parts that are suitable for B-Roll. And then you can edit the AI settings for if you want to add an AI-generated image. And here you can let AI automatically find sections for your B-roll or manually add sections. But of course, this video is about AI, so there we go. Let AI do its thing. Auto find. And then just click on each section to add B-roll. And the cool thing is that it already suggests you some B-roll based on the context, but it still lets you decide which one you want to use. Or you can also let AI generate an image and then just select the image you want and done. And then once you're done with all this, just add the B-rolls. So if you work with a lot of stock footage for your B-roll, this is a feature that could potentially save you a lot of time. This is a super simple one. This is a tool to automatically censor your video, especially in podcasts, you know, 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours long. It's nice to have a tool that does it automatically. And the only thing I can say is that, yeah, it works. It transcribes your video, detects words. You can also save words to a library for automatic censorship in future projects. It just works. AutoCut Repeat. This is a feature that could potentially be a crazy time saver. It's similar to IntelliScript in DaVinci Resolve 20. And the idea is basically that, for example, when you're recording a talking head video, like I'm doing right now, you make mistakes, right? And you have to repeat stuff. Well, this AI feature automatically identifies all those repeated parts so that you can remove them in just a few seconds, basically, without having to go over all your footage manually. So it transcribes your video and then it shows you everything. And of course, you can still do manual adjustments if you want. Now, in DaVinci Resolve, IntelliScript works a bit differently. You have to first upload your script as a text file, and then it will cut your video clip based on that script and put it on different tracks and things like that. But the thing is, it kind of works, both of them, but not good enough to, you know, save time. There's always too much work still that you have to do manually, both with AutoCut and DaVinci Resolve. So yeah, it's definitely not there yet. But look, if they can improve this feature and perfect it, then wow, that's gonna be a crazy time saver, but still needs a lot of improvement. This is a super cool and, well, yeah, also a useful feature in my opinion. AutoViral transforms your long video into short, potentially viral clips that you can then upload to Instagram as a reel or to YouTube as a short, TikTok, whatever. So this is a long video that I made a while back and I wanted to use the entire timeline. And then it will transcribe the video and detect parts that have the potential to become a viral short clip. It even gives them a score. Now, I don't always agree with the score, and sometimes you also have to edit a little bit, you know, add an extra sentence, for example. But there's always a few clips that I'm like, yeah, that's a great short. And then all you have to do is select the ones you like, and it will automatically take those clips and put them each on a separate timeline with a title and everything. So that's really cool because you can feel that AI understands what's being said and the context, and that it understands concepts, I guess, to create these clips that make sense. So yeah, it's cool. I like this one. And then finally, there's Auto Chapters. Look, creating the chapters for videos like this, the ones that you see down here, so that you can easily navigate the timeline, I mean, it doesn't take like super long to make them, but it's a bit of an annoying little task because you manually have to add it to the description of your video, right? But AutoChapters does it all automatically, and I must say, it's kind of impressive because I did the test with a video that I uploaded a few weeks ago for which I added chapters manually. So this video has chapters with these title cards, right? That's what I usually do in my videos. But then once uploaded to YouTube, I have to manually add those chapters in the description so that YouTube shows them underneath the video. So what I did now to test AutoCut is I removed all those chapters, the title cards, I mean, and then I also deleted the empty spaces so that there's no gaps, so that You know, AutoCut can't recognize that that's a chapter. And then I let AutoCut detect the chapters. And once it's done, it adds them as markers above the timeline. See? The green things here. And you know what? They're almost identical to the chapters I created manually. The only difference is that I think it added an extra chapter somewhere here, but it made sense. So, you know, and I also had to slightly adjust one chapter. It missed a few words. But other than that, yeah, really impressive. And then when you export the video and you use the upload directly to YouTube setting with chapters from markers checked, it will automatically add those chapters in the video description, which is really, really cool. Just make sure that you select the correct color here for the markers. Not blue, but green. So, yeah, I have to say, some of these features are actually really impressive and super useful. And sure, some of them are not perfect yet, but they certainly have potential. So, depending on what kind of creator you are, AutoCut might be a great choice for you. But for others, DaVinci Resolve 20 Studio maybe is the better choice. So, you know, up to you to decide. But you can try it out for free. So, I mean, just try it out and then let me know what you think. Would you use any of these features? Or is it just, you know, AI gimmicks for you? Let me know in the comments. Let's have a discussion about it. And thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.